to students, construction houses, etc. These development and welfare measures led to compound annual growth of 13.5% between 2014 to 2019. While the state was set to take off on the path of high growth, the change of regime in 2019 again brought back the disturbing time for the nascent Andhra Pradesh. The state that already bore threat of bifurcation in 2014 was rather unfortunate to have witnessed yet another bigger debacle in the form of inept governance, where the people were threatened and officers demoralized. In fact, the damage and losses during the period 2019-24 have been more severe compared to the state reorganization in June 2014. The government that assumed charge in 2019 started a destructive note with demolition of Praja Vedike that continued unabated till the end of the regime 2024. During this regime, democracy was at peril. People were in a state of fear and hardly enjoyed any freedom of living. The regime revenge politics had severely hampered the state's prospects for prosperity and growth. Even the Honorable High Court of Andhra Pradesh had sought to convene a judicial inquiry into whether there is a constitutional breakdown in the state. The biggest damage was done to the brand AP. No noteworthy companies came forward to invest in the state. The corrupt practices at all levels, coupled with weaponization of instruments of governance across revenue earning departments for personal gains, sabotaging of checks and balances, made several state institutions and private companies defunct and forced the existing enthusiastic investors and entrepreneurs to move out of Andhra Pradesh to other states. The uncertain environment, which rocked the confidence of the people in general and investors in particular, started showing impact on the state finances, leaving them in a mess. Fiscal prudence was abandoned. Expenditure was beyond means in spite of limited revenue growth, and debt and liabilities rose sharply. Financial management is manifested by diversion of funds, higher taxation despite high inflation, increase in power sector liabilities, neglect of capital expenditure, which eventually resulted in slowing down of the economy. The enormous gap in resources was sought to be met repeatedly by borrowings through corporations and forcing them to spend on government expenditure, and in the process weakening the corporations. In view of the inordinate delay in clearance of the bills due to strained financial position of the state, many vendors and contractors have approached High Court of Andhra Pradesh for relief and filed cases against the government. About 25,000 cases have been filed for bill payments, which is unprecedented. The sheer number of contempt cases with personal appearances and arrest warrants against officials in several cases resulted in systematic humiliation and victimization of bureaucracy. This led to complete demoralization of administrative machinery. The capital expenditure reduced by 60% in 2019-24 compared to 2014-19. Departments such as water resources and transport, roads and buildings, which undertake substantial capital works, were left critically short of funds to carry out any works. The capital expenditure on water resources has reduced by 56%, and that on roads and buildings by an alarming 85% during this period. The compound annual growth rate of state's own tax revenue slipped from 12.8% to 8.1% during this period. On the other hand, the revenue expenditure increased from 7.8% to 10.5%, whereas the capital expenditure growth declined steeply from 26.4% to 3.4%. Lower share of capital expenditure to public debt occurred during the period 2019 to 24 is a clear indicator that the government met revenue expenditure also through borrowed funds. The CAGR in per capita debt has been higher at 14%, while the CAGR in per capita income is only 9.7%. This reflects the fiscal profligacy of the previous regime, as no capital formation took place. The Amaravati capital region, envisioned as the focal point of growth for the nascent state of Andhra Pradesh, was totally destroyed. With an attempt to scrap the Amaravati dream, the government confused the people with its malicious three capital cities idea under the guise of decentralized governance. During the period 2019-24, no irrigation project, no industries, no infrastructure relating to roads, buildings, hospitals, drinking water was taken up. Cancellation of MOUs in energy sector and other infrastructure projects further demonstrated the negative attitude of the government. Such disastrous decisions, unmindful of consequences, have led to unrest among the youth and job aspirants. Prevalence of uncertain environment has eventually led the youth towards addiction of illegal substances, causing a drug menace. The mental unrest and agony were not limited to the geographical boundaries of the state. The Telugu speaking people all around the world were upset and demoralized by